Hello and welcome to TradingFloor.com's weekly Asia Focus. The Australian economy saw negative growth of 1.2% in the first quarter, making it the worst national economic contraction in 20 years. Though a contraction was expected, the amount was greater than expected. And to interpret this data and give his take on the status of the commodity-driven economy and its strong currency is Andrew Robinson, correspondent of Saxo Capital Markets. Welcome, Andrew.
Hello again.
So is the Australian economy in recession mode, or is this just a reflection of the floods in Queensland earlier this year? And can we expect a rebound in the months ahead?
I think yes. Obviously, the natural disasters that hit Queensland were a major factor in the headline number. It came in at minus 1.2% quarter on quarter, as you said, the worst in 20 years. But just prior to the data release, the market was thinking that maybe following yesterday's very bad current account data, that the numbers could be a lot worse. Rumours were somewhere between 1.5-2%. So when it came in at 1.2%, I think there was quite a relief that it wasn't as bad as it could have been, shall we say. And not forgetting that the major drag on the GDP numbers was the export sector. If we look at the domestic consumption, it actually rose 1.3% quarter on quarter. So that's still showing quite robust demand within the domestic sector. So I think, yes, it was a bad number. But I don't think Australia is heading for a recession. I think obviously we need to wait for the next quarter's data to filter out all this bad news and just see how it comes out, really.
So we could expect some kind of a bounce back in the next few months?
I think so, yes. Generally, the major factor is that it was the exports, certainly the resources, the coal sector and the iron ore sector was the major drag. And so I think overall, markets are still willing to look through this negative headline and still see that Australia is possibly still on track for positive growth.
And if we look more closely at the disappointing performance of commodity exports in the current account, which you mentioned, which showed an overall 29% increase in the deficit from the slower exports. Are the floods the main reason for this diminishing demand, or is Asia perhaps also an explanatory factor?
I think for the headline numbers this quarter, certainly the Queensland floods were a major factor. But it's something that we've been focusing on in recent months, that the fact that the Australian economy is starting to become a bit of a one-trick pony, that the resource sector and the exports to China are the main driving force. We're a bit concerned that once China, or if China starts to slow down, that these imports will slow. And Australia basically has nothing else to fall back on. So I think there is a concern there, but I do feel that we need to wait until the next quarter's data to see whether it was purely dependent on these natural disasters or whether there is some more hidden data within those numbers.
And how about the reaction from the Aussie dollar?
Well, I think the fact that there was positive domestic consumption, that's the thing that the market focused on, plus the fact that the numbers were not quite as bad as the early rumours. So we saw a quick 50-point jump in the Aussie. Market's willing to look past the headline numbers. But we didn't manage to break the 107.50 level. I think that's becoming quite a crucial number for the markets to focus on. When I left my desk, we were around about 107.40, but yet to break convincingly this 107.50. So that's a really strong number to monitor. If we cannot break it this time around, then chances are that we're facing a 150-300-point retracement before we stand any chance of getting any higher.
And the manufacturing sector, it's been of discussions of late. So today's PMI data, has that shown that the sector's still struggling from the firm Aussie dollar?
Yes, I think so. We saw the manufacturing PMI weaker than the previous month, and now we are 8 months out of 9 months, we've been below the 50 threshold, which is the threshold between contraction and expansion. So I would say, yes, the manufacturing sector is struggling to keep its head above water. And so, yes, will the strong Aussie continue to impact that? The RBA has already admitted that they do know that the manufacturing sector is struggling from this strong Aussie effect. So, yes, we'll have to see how the authorities can monitor that one.
And on the note of the RBA, the Reserve Bank of Australia, it has a rate meeting next week. So against this backdrop, what are the expectations?
I think, yes, if you look at the headline numbers, then there's a natural assumption that there won't be any move in interest rates in later this month. But if you look at the domestic consumption side of thing, then yes, there is also an argument for a rate increase come next week. Personally, I think the RBA is willing to hold pat. I don't think they will move on interest rates next week, and we'll see status quo.
Thank you for this report, Andrew. And don't forget to follow him and other colleagues on TradingFloor.com.